What's going on? This is your boy Imperial Negus. I am reviewing The Lifestyle featuring Young Thug played in court case, full arguments. And what I want to explain today to you is that lyrical terminology or content will be used against you in a court of law according to this new law. But you have to know that lyrical content are metaphors, and metaphors just impact the streets. And in court, it doesn't hold any weight, because versus legal terms that are used in court, it makes rap lyrics look very unprofessional, especially when they don't come from a positive state. So it's almost like something led us down to this court system where our lyrical content doesn't hold weight against these legal terms and these statements and these things. In this particular case with Young Thug, he is taken through something called an 802DA. And an 802DA kind of case is based upon statements. And statements are said all throughout this court. But for the most part, when, you know, snitches make statements, it can impact you in court. When people make statements against you, it can impact in court. Now, when you look at the word statement in legal terms, you'll find that there's a meaning to it. And the meaning to it is a statement is an oral, right? Somebody saying something about you, right? Or is a written assertion, right? Pay attention to that written assertion. Somebody can have a written statement against you, or it could even be a nonverbal conduct of a person. A person doesn't have to say anything. He can just point you out. He can tell other officers about, you know, you and have evidence against you, but not want to be seen in that way. You know, like say, you know, like the mob, you got witness protection, things like that. Some people don't want to show their face, but they're witnesses. So, you know, those things can happen. So there are nonverbal conducts of snitching, right? There's oral snitching. There's written snitching. So there's different type of snitching. So know your terms, right? So, but let's go over the legal terms in the lifestyle case, and let's just be more on point with what goes on in court versus what goes on the street. Because in the street, they could be hindering what actually goes on in court, and that doesn't prepare you for what goes on in court. So you want to be fully aware of what goes on in court. So in this particular case here, you'll find that the judge is putting here, he looked blind right here, right? Because there ain't nothing but a blind jury and a blind judge. Nah, but for the most part, the court, the judge is put in a position where he got to listen to the lifestyle song and try to figure out, well, okay, how can I justify this, right? Knowing that I don't want to look bad where I'm just condemning rap lyrics or condemning Young Thug, right? He's paying good money for his lawyers, and it's clear that he's a successful man, right? And this gains a lot of attention and clout. But for the most part, let's see what this case is about. So let's start off with the case. It said this.
Judge, there was one matter that Mr. Steele brought to our attention. I don't know if he intends
sure.
to.
What is it?
He had intended to introduce a video. I don't know if he intends to do that today, but if he does, it's a matter that would probably be best to argue it outside the presence of the jury. He served it on us this morning that he intended to do that. So
how long is that video?
It's 4 minutes, maybe.
Okay, have you all looked at it?
Yes, we've looked at it. We contend that it is inadmissible through Mr. Stevens by Mr. Steele under 24-8-801-D2A. It's his client's video.
You see that? You see that code right there? Here it is.
Stevens by Mr. Steele under 24-8.
You see that right there? 24-8-801-D2A. Look like a damn serial number, right? But it's important that you look that up and you investigate. What is that 24-8-801-D2A? We cannot keep putting our lives in the hands of these lawyers without doing the work, researching, understanding what is this thing, right? And why is it there? You know, and 24-8-801-D2A is based on statements. right? Statements that are nonverbal, that are oral, that are written, right? Things that hold weight up in court. Now, that sounds very similar, right, to, you know, some of the dry snitching that's going on in rap, right? Some of the dry snitching, oh, I killed your brother, I killed this, and then some of the things that we're saying that may be incriminating us, depending on how real it is. But because the things that we're saying just may hold some weight, they can throw it under 2488-01-D2A and say, hey, this may be something we can use. You know, this person's in a gang. This person's with criminals. This person, you know, should be held under RICO. So we got to be careful in understanding what a statement is and what the 2488-01-D2A consists of. And these are statements. Now let's go in it. And then, first of all, the song was inadmissible, according to her. And you know what? And think about it. It was unnecessary to play the song 4 minutes through. But we're going to go
1D2A.
We're going to move on.
Client's video. Maybe outside the presence of the jury who served it on us this morning that he intended to do that.
So, mom's a video.
So, as they look for the video. And of course, you know, they play the entire song.
One time's enough, Mr. Kokomo. All right, okay.
You know, so he made a little joke, you know, one time is enough to play the song. And we're moving on in the case, right? All right. So we get to this point. Legal terms are about to be used at this point. It's important that you comb through every legal term that is used because it is held against Mr. Jeffrey over here, my man Young Thug.
So, Mr. Steele, you want me to admit this, and what's the reason? I suppose you're gonna lay a foundation through Mr. Stevens.
Stop. Lay a foundation through Mr. Stevens. Now, before we just skim through that, what is that foundation? Like, lay a foundation. I mean, we kind of know what it is, but, you know, just going through legal terms, I mean, you know, it'd be nice to kind of figure out, like, okay, like, you know, what is a foundation? Now, foundation is the base, right? You want to have a base of your case, right? It is a necessary factual and legal base for a judge or jury to consider specific evidence and apply it to a larger use, right? So when it says it is a necessary factual and legal base for a judge, right, or a jury, right, or in this case, a lawyer, right, this way they lay it down and consider specific evidence and apply it to a larger issue, right? So you want to make sure that your base is set up so that way, you know, you can close the case or close the day with something strong. Should be a base to all your conversations.
Yes, that is true. And
if you want to make a point,
that foundation is laid to this honorable court's satisfaction, and the court admits it. There are three things that are pertinent to this video. You will look, if you don't mind, or may remember, in overt act number 14 of count one, you will see a photograph that the grand jury attached to that charge. And it's Mr. Williams along with Mr. Copeland. It's a Instagram posting, allegedly with Mr. Williams' Instagram handle. and they're wearing shirts that you see in this video. The shirts are RG, and RG, it would be my contention, stands for Rich Gang. And Rich Gang, we're here with, you know, an allegation of a criminal street gang, and I want the jurors, I think I'm entitled, I would like to, entitled to show the jurors what Rich Gang is. That is their music compilation. Number two, there is a lot of red being worn in the video that has been just played for the Ensemble Court, which I believe is number 31. If I'm wrong, it's 32. Okay, thank you. And Mr. Williams is not wearing red in the video. It is being worn by other people. The third reason, Your Honor, is there are two witnesses on the state's witness list. Mr. Brian Williams, his performing name is Birdman. And Mr., of course, I can't remember. It's Lamar. I can't remember his first name.
Okay, so what he's saying basically is that, yes, there's red being worn in the V, but, hey, listen, Rich Gang started out as a company, a compilation strictly about business, and their business has brought them to a point where Mr. Young Thug, Jeffrey, has been successful from this business, and he's strictly about business. And just because Birdman and Rich Homie Quan take the stand doesn't mean anybody's snitching. It just means that they're speaking up for the fact that Jeffrey was a businessman. So all that rhetoric online talking about, oh, yeah, you see, they testifying against him. How could they testify against him? What are they going to say? What is Birdman and Rich Homie Quan going to say on the stand?